Welcome back. Today we're going to read Genesis 17, verse 15 through 27. Sarai is named Sarah. Then God added regarding Sarai, your wife, her name will no longer be Sarai. From now on, you will call her Sarah, and I will bless her and give you a son from her. Yes, I will bless her richly, and she will become the mother of many nations. Kings will be among her descendants. Then Abraham bowed down to the ground, but he laughed to himself in disbelief. How could I become a father at the age of 100? He wondered. Besides, Sarah is 90. How could she have a baby? And Abraham said to God, yes, may Ishmael enjoy your special blessing. But God replied, Sarah, your wife will bear you a son. You will name him Isaac, and I will confirm my everlasting covenant with him and his descendants. As for Ishmael, I will bless him also, just as you have asked. I will cause him to multiply and become a great nation. 12 princes will be among his descendants, but my covenant is with Isaac, who will be born to you and Sarah about this time next year. That ended the conversation, and God left Abraham on that very day. And God left Abraham. On that very day, Abraham took his son Ishmael and every other male in his household and circumcised them, cutting off their foreskins, exactly as God had told him. Abraham was 99 years old at that time, and Ishmael, his son, was 13. Both were circumcised the same day, along with all the other men and boys of the household, whether they were born there or bought as servants. That is it for today's video. Sarai is named Sarah. Now, as far as why God had circumcision, I think I made a video questioning that also. Why would God do this? I don't know why God did certain things and why he would allow certain things, or at the very least not intervene in certain matters of humanity's general activities or general happenings in humanity's lives, in human lives. Why he wouldn't intervene, I don't know. And why he would ask for certain things, I don't know. I do wish that he would have intervened way at the beginning of the fall of the enemy, the fall of Lucifer, when before that happened. I wish he wouldn't have created him if he knew, or that he would have sent him straight to hell instead of allowing him to intervene in people's lives. So we can have wishes or have our own thoughts and thinking, but that's not the way it happened. I don't know why, and I don't know what's going to happen in the future in regards to humans and the supernatural pertaining to God and the devil himself. I don't know why God allowed any of these things to happen, why he allowed Adam and Eve to be deceived, why he allows a lot of us to go through things, whether it be through deception or believing things that we're not supposed to believe or things that are not accurate or true. I really don't know. But that's been it for this video. Sarai is named Sarah. That's the end of chapter 17. And on the next video, we'll be reading chapter 18. Genesis chapter 18, a son promised to Sarah. So thank you all for watching. God bless you all very much. And I will see you in the next.